Hello children, so far you have learned the basic concept of mathematics like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So I hope you have understood. So next let us move to measurement. So first let us see measurement of length. So what is measurement of length? See children, you might have observed when you go for shops to buy your clothes. So there you won't ask you some cloth, isn't it? You will ask the particular size of the cloth. So how do you know that size? In the same way, when you go for buying grocery like sugar or then some vegetables or fruits, etc., you will say the correct quantity, 1 kg, 2 kg, etc., isn't it? So you don't say give some sugar, give some salt, etc. You will say the particular quantity. So they are all the measurements, okay? They are all the measurements. So first let us see measurement of length. So measurement of length means measuring the length or height of an object or to know how long an object is. So here I have two bottles, okay. So by looking at these two objects, if I ask which one is longer, you will easily say that this bottle is longer one, isn't it? So this is longer one. If I ask you how long it is, how long it is, can you tell me how long it is? To know how long it is, we have to measure the length of this bottle, isn't it? We should measure the length of this bottle. So let us see how to measure the length. Children, in earlier days, people used to measure objects using their body parts. Okay, they used to measure using their body parts. For example, the tip of your thumb and tip of your finger, last finger or a small finger. The distance between these two is called as hand span. Okay, this length is called as hand span. So, like this if you measure from here to here, like this. If you measure in this way, this is called as hand span. So, this board is 1, 2, then 3 hand span long. You can say that it is 3 hand span. I can say that it is 3 hand span long. In the same way for this bottle, see, like this, 1, 2. So, it is nearly 2 hand span long. Okay, so this length is called as hand span. Next, from the elbow, from here to the tip of the finger, this length is called as cubit. Okay, this length is called as cubit. So if you measure like this, okay, if you measure like this, it is called as cubit. So this bottle is nearly 1 cubit long. Okay, 1 cubit long, like that. Next, from the ankle to the tip of the toe. So that is called as foot length or foot span. And if you use both the foot, one after the another, and if you measure the object, that is called as pace. Okay. So we have hand span, then cubit, foot span, then pace. So, these are all called as non-standard units of length because they vary from person to person. So, in my hand span, if I measure this length of this board, I will get 1, 2, 3 hand span. And if you measure the same length, it might be in your hand 4 hand span length. In my hand it is 3, in your hand it will be 4 because my hand is longer one or bigger one, your hand is quite smaller compared to my hand, so you will get more hand span, more length. Clear? So which one is correct here? Which is the actual length of the board? Can you decide easily? Not possible, isn't it? So these lengths, they differ from person to person. If a baby measures the same, it will be still more than your hand span, isn't it? Because its hand is quite smaller. So like that, they are all non-standard units because they vary from person to person. Clear? Hence, to measure, to get the actual length, to get the correct length, we have standard units of length. So, which is the standard unit of length? It is called as meter. Okay? It is called as meter. So, standard unit of length is called as meter. It is shortly written as small letter M. So, this is the standard unit of length. Okay? So, whoever measures in the meter scale, so everyone gets the same length. So, we are using different objects like scale, then tape, etc. for measuring the length in the meter. Okay? And meter is the unit of length, standard unit of length, used to measure longer lengths like length of the wall, length of the door, etc. Okay? They are all used, measured using meter scale. And smaller lengths like length of the pen or length of the duster. So, these are all smaller lengths and they are measured using smaller length called centimeter. So, shortly written as cm. So, meter used for longer lengths. Measuring longer lengths like length of the door, length of the wall, etc. And centimeter is the smaller unit of length used to measure smaller objects like length of the pencil or length of the pen, then duster, etc. These are all smaller objects and they are measured using centimeter. So here is a scale, okay. This is a scale, quite longer one, and here it is measured from 0 to 30, written 0 to 30. You might have smaller scale, isn't it? So, in that it will be written from 0 to 15. So, here from 0 to 1 it is 1 centimeter. From 1 to 2 it is 2 centimeter. From 2 to 3 it is 3 centimeter. Like that, okay? So, we can measure in this way. So, start from 0. Then hold the pencil like this. Where it ends, so take that marking. Nearly it is here 14 in the scale. Can you see it is 14 in the scale? So, see here 14. So, this pen is 14 centimeter long. We can say that the pen is 14 centimeter long. Like that. Okay. So, from here you have to start with 0 and should see where it ends in the scale. So, it was ended in the 14 centimeter. So, even if you measure in your scale, the length of the pen remains same. Okay. Length of the pen remains same. It will be 14 centimeter only. Hence, it is called a standard unit of length. Clear? So, 1 meter is equal to, so if you join 100 centimeters, it will be 1 meter. To get 1 meter, we should have 100 centimeters. So, 1 meter, 1m is equal to 100 centimeter. In the cloth shop, well, when you go for purchasing cloths, you will, there you can see long scale, like this long scale. So, that is called as meter scale. It will be measuring 1 meter. Okay, means 100 centimeter. In that, there will be 100 marks. 0 to 100. How you have here 0 to 30, you know, like that. If it continued from 0 to 100, that is called 1 meter. So, these are the standard units of length. Meter is used for measuring longer lengths. Centimeter is used for measuring smaller lengths. So, if you have scale, use that scale and measure different objects with your scale. Okay? So, this is about measurement of length. In the next class, let us see measurement of weight. Thank you.